is the case of the 43 students. Because I really have learned many things in the last 3 years. These fathers, these mothers and fathers, very poor, the parents of these students, I think that have given a big lesson of dignity and love, not just in Mexico, in the world, because they are really fighting against one monster that became the Mexican government. And it's incredible for me that every September 20, every 26th day in every month, they go to protest to remember us that this case is in June. I was able to discover by 2 years of investigation that the students really were attacked. Who coordinate all the attack against the students was the colonel of the 27th battalion. I don't know if you remember the story, but the Mexican government, when this happened, the Mexican government said, we didn't know anything about the attack. We were noticed about the attack 2 hours after the attack occurred. Was just the mayor, his crazy wife, this very little local police that did it. The army wasn't there, the federal police wasn't there. I mean, was just a very local problem and a very local gang apparently involved in all these things. I went to Iguala, I traveled to Iguala on October of 2014, and I was able to investigate the case from zero, because I really understand that many of the versions of the government were fed. For example, the government said, start to arrest too many people that supposedly confessed, yes, I killed him, yes, was a major, yes, we need it, we burned them. But what I discovered is that more than 80% of the people, and I'm talking about more than 130 people that have been arrested in this case, more than the 80% were brutally tortured. And they signed confessions of one crime that where they never participate. So I was able to start to find a lot of documents that shows that was false, the version of the government, that through the C4, that is the police office in Iguala, that were under control of the military that night. All the military or the 27th Battalion, the Federal Police, also the members of the PGR, members of the State Police, and some members of the Municipal Police were noticed about the students even 3 hours before they arrived to Iguala. The federal government start to follow the students 3 hours before they arrived to Iguala. So this, what happened that night, was a plan, was not an accident, was something that was planified, at least by many hours before the attack occurred. What I was able to discover through the testimonies of the witness, common people that were during the attack, because this attack occurred in the streets of this city, didn't occur in one solitary place. This occurred in the middle of hundreds of witness. People start to tell me that not just people with uniforms of the police were shooting against the buses where the students were transporting. They start to say that many of these people that were shooting were people dressed as civilians. And I hear this version in the different points where the attack occurred. So when I start to request to the people, okay, how these civilians looks in one point of the city, spontaneously, the people said, looks like a military. In another point of the city, they said, looks like a military. I said, it's not possible. Because I asked many times to the survivors, to the students that survived that night, if they saw military there, uniforms, something, and they said, no, nothing. We just saw some policemen and that's all. We couldn't see nothing because was everything very dark. So after these first testimonies, I asked the Mexican government, give me all the depositions, if they exist, made by the members of the 27th Battalion related with the case. I was the first journalist that asked for this because I really want to clarify what the people were saying. And what I discovered after a litigation, I had to use one law that exists in Mexico that forced to the Mexican government to give to the citizens information, even if it is classified when it is related with human rights violations. So what I discovered is that the colonel, the head of the 27th Battalion, in his confession that the PGR tried to hide forever, he admit, we were there. I sent to the different points where the attack occurred, military dressed as civilians. And when I got these documents, I really start to understand, okay, yes, the people, the witness were not lying, were not drunk. I mean, they really saw militaries shooting against the students. So also, I was able to prove with documents that in two of the scenes of this crime were bullets that belongs to the guns that the army was carrying on that night. I mean, it's not any doubt that at least 24 members of the 27th Battalion participate directly in the shooting against the students, in the shooting. So I was able to publish this information, and I have said that I continue with my investigation. And I think that I will be able to find them because the students never were born.